for some of the good plays of points with smothering offense and a speed that's like getting run over by a freight train.
It's breaking. You've got Keith Lee, who comes from something limitless. And it's actually kind of scary to think about a 300-plus pounder being limitless.
Well, he's a super heavyweight. He's moves around in that ring like a cruiserweight fighter. It must be scary, but it's also impressive. Body, that hurt. He's definitely being the aggressor here, just producing an onslaught.
We're going to see it, gentlemen.
There it comes. Just carrying the opposition here.
Are you kidding me?
Lars Sullivan feeling some pressure here. It's nothing he hasn't been through before. Keatley is just so impressive. It's hard to understand how a man his size can move the way he does. It's even hard to understand how to stop him once he gets started.
He has an ego the size of Byron's bald spot.
But as a man his size, his speed and agility, there's good reason for that. If possible, the best bet against basking in his glory is to avoid, evade, and tire him out as much as possible. You can try to bring a fight to him, but I would suggest it.
Bald spot? Well, listen, you're just bad at how real I am. Just so you know.
Leaving the ring here may change the entire complexion of this match. He's looking to fly. Oh my God! Keith Lee calls himself limitless. What exactly does that mean?
And how does it matter to yourself?
Exactly what we are seeing.
Just a step quicker. Say what you will about that. He's definitely effective.
Effective. Encounter thus far.
The tides have swung in multiple directions. It's anyone's guess how this one's gonna end.
He's executing on his plan perfectly.
Things are playing out
exactly how he envisioned. Here's another look.